and next to economic policy and the nation's debt and deficits. More than 9 months after it was created, today was the day for President Obama's bipartisan fiscal commission to put its plan up for a vote. Here again is Judy Woodruff.
11 of the commission's 18 members supported a blueprint for fiscal austerity offered by the co-chairman. That was three short of the supermajority needed to trigger an up or down vote in Congress. Still, co-chair Erskine Bowles, a former Clinton White House chief of staff, insisted the commission delivered a wake-up call to the country.
I think people really believe that this is the moment of truth, that the threat of these deficits are real. The solutions are absolutely going to be painful. There's no way around it. And there is no easy way out.
Republican co-chair Alan Simpson, a former Wyoming senator, had a more colorful view of the outcome.
We took a big banana and threw it into the gorilla cage. And the gorilla has picked it up like they do. They peel it, mash it, play with it, but they will eat some. And that's where we are right now, because, and so it is with this, many pieces of this will be digested and nourish this country.
Those pieces included recommendations to raise the retirement age to 68 for full Social Security benefits by 2050, reduce future increases in Social Security benefits, and eliminate some tax breaks and curb others, including the child tax credit and mortgage interest deduction. In exchange, the plan calls for corporate and individual income tax rates to be simplified and cut. Overall, the package would shave nearly $4 billion from the federal budget over the next decade. It won the surprise backing today of a key Democrat on the commission, Illinois Senator Dick Durbin. Another yes vote, North Dakota Democratic Senator Kent Conrad, said getting 11 votes was an achievement in view of strong opposition from the left and the right.
So I never thought there was much prospect of getting 14 votes, but we're going to get 11. 11 of 18, by my math, is 60%. In fact, it's a little over 60%. So I believe we've crossed an important hurdle here and laid out a plan that will be resurrected, because it must be.
One of the plan's opponents agreed. Andy Stern is a former president of the Service Employees International Union.
The Bowles-Simpson plan got 60% of the votes. It deserves a vote. You know, whoever made the rule up of 14, we made it up.
In a statement, President Obama praised the commission's work without backing any specifics. Instead, he said it underscores that to sustain growth in the medium and long term, we need to face some difficult choices to curb runaway debt. The president said his economic team will consider the proposal in working up a budget for the coming year.